A very good morning, class. So here I'm going to talk about last class from our kingdom fungi, and finally we are going to finish this fungi kingdom, right? Deuteromycetes. We just finished with the basidiomycetes, right? So now I'm taking into consideration that is the deuteromycetes. This fungi is known as imperfect fungi, or it is known as fungi imperfecti also. Imperfecti. This is known as imperfecti fungi or imperfect fungi also. Why? The reason it is known as imperfect fungi. Why? Because sexual reproduction is absent in this class. Sexual reproduction is completely absent, not known. That is why it is known as imperfect fungi. And if any member of this class that has perfect stages, they are found, reproduction is found, then they don't belong to this class. They are belonging to the ascomycetes and basidiomycetes. Asexual or vegetative stage of fungus, fungus which is having the asexual or vegetative stage, it is given the name deuteromycetes because it is not having the sexual reproductive structure. But with the sexual reproductive structure, they are keeping in the other classes. The members of deuteromycetes, they are saprophytes as well as they are parasites. But large number, the maximum number or the members of deuteromycetes, they are decomposed. They are decomposers of the litter. And you can imagine those which are decomposing the litter. It means they are helping us in the mineral cycling. Mycelium is again branched and septate. Because they reproduce vegetatively, asexually, so the spores which reproduce, that is known as your conidia, right? They reproduce through the conidia, or the which are produced in the structure which is known as conidiophore, right? So conidia is the main structure, or the spores which are produced asexually in this class. Very common example, Alternaria, Coleotrichum, Trichoderma. These are the examples of this group. But other than, there are few examples which are extremely important for us. And one of the examples of this class, Deuteromycetes, is Helminthosporium oryzae. बहुत बार बच्चे बोलते हैं, मैम कैसे याद करें इतनी सारी एग्जाम्पल, मैंने पहले भी बताया है. एक एग्जाम्पल बच्चा माइंड में रखनी है जो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट रोल प्ले करती हो, जैसे कि Helminthosporium oryzae. Why it is so important for us? क्योंकि इसमें से क्वेश्चन आता है, एक बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन आता है, मैं बताती हूँ. That it cause brown spot of leaf in case of rice, right? So now what happened, one time in Bengal, they have their main diet, they eat rice. So this Helminthosporium, it destroyed their complete rice crop, and that time is known as Bengal famine. This when the whole crop of rice was destroyed, it is known as Bengal famine. So this was caused by the Helminthosporium oryzae. Aap kisi se pad lo. These are the few points jo aapko mind mein rakhne hain whenever you are reading from my lectures. Please इनको छोटे छोटे notes में बना के रखो. These are going to, you will remember कि ये आपको बहुत ज़्यादा काम आने वाले हैं. Helminthosporium oryzae, this causes Bengal famine because this cause brown spot of leaf in rice. The another very common example, very interesting example, is Gibberella fugicori. This deuteromycetes, it releases a phytohormone which is known as gibberellic acid. And this gibberellic acid is responsible for internodal elongation. Usko bada deta hai, elongate kar deta hai. And this belongs to these both examples, Helminthosporium and Gibberella fugicori. They belong to the deuteromycetes. And deuteromycetes is known as the fungi imperfecti kyunki uske paas sexual reproduction totally absent hai, right? So this year we are finished with the kingdom fungi. But before I wind up this lecture, I'm going to take you to the very common examples, very important examples, main example from a complete kingdom. Like we discussed about the Neurospora. Neurospora, if you recall, it belonged to the Ascomycetes, right? इट इज़ द अगर एस्कोमाइसिटिस ना याद आ रहा हो, वैसे तो होता नहीं है कि एस्कोमाइसिटिस मेरे बच्चों को ना याद आए, क्योंकि हमने उसमें यीस्ट पढ़ा था, हमने उसमें पेंसिलियम पढ़ा था, राइट? सो इट इज़ नोन एज न्यूरोस्पोरा की क्या कहानी है, न्यूरोस्पोरा इज़ नोन एज ड्रोसोफिला ऑफ प्लांट किंगडम. अब ये मैम आप बोलोगे, मैम ये ड्रोसोफिला, ड्रोसोफिला इज़ अ फ्रूट फ्लाई विच इज़ वेरी वेरी फेमस अमंग द रिसर्चर्स, क्योंकि वो उसको जेनेटिक स्टडी के लिए बहुत ज़्यादा यूज़ करते हैं ड्रोसोफिला को, राइट? तो सेम, जब भी कभी किसी को प्लांट जेनेटिक्स में काम करना है तो न्यूरोस्पोरा बहुत हेल्पफुल होता है स्टडी करने के लिए. सो इट इज़ यूज्ड इन द रिसर्च वर्क इन द जेनेटिक्स, इसीलिए इसको ड्रोसोफिला ऑफ प्लांट किंगडम, वी कॉल इट एज अ ड्रोसोफिला ऑफ प्लांट किंगडम, राइट? सो it belong to which class of fungi? Ascomycetes. Then there is the Phytophthora infestans. Phytophthora मैंने शायद नहीं आपके साथ डिस्कस किया था, बट अगेन इट इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन ऑफ नीट. Phytophthora infestans इज अ बिलोंग टू Phycomycetes. इट causes लेट ब्लाइट ऑफ पोटैटो. किसी के भी नोट्स उठा लो, कितने भी आप नोट्स देखोगे तो दीज आर द डिजीजेज विच आर मैंशनड देयर. These are important ones. So Phytophthora infestans, it causes late blight of potato. Same, exact like the, जैसे Helminthosporus, Helminthosporium was responsible for Bengal famine. This Phytophthora, it is responsible for Irish famine. In the Ireland, what happened? Their staple diet, their main food was potato. And this fungus, Phytophthora, it infected their complete crop of potato. And that is known as Irish famine, right? After this, the fungi is also, you know, known, is where we use fungi, it is used in the mainly in the antibiotics. As you know that penicillin is obtained from the Penicillium fungi. Then yeast is used in the baking as well as the brewing industry. Then aspergillus is used for the production of many acids like oxalic acid, citric acid. Then we discussed today that agaricus campestris and biospora, these are the two fungi which are you can eat also. So these are the few common uses of fungi which you can consider for your subjective exam. And other, there are few small points like Phytophthora, Neurospora, Helminthosporium oryzae, as well as Gibberella fugicori. These are the points which you have to take care for your NEET purpose. So next I will take with you in the detail, that is about the viruses, and we will wind up this chapter, right? Till then, all of you with your fresh mind and study, get ready to study with me the another important chapters, and I will meet you with the viruses.